Hello and welcome to the course. In this lecture, I will tell you different data sources that are available for Power BI Desktop. First of all, we have to see how to download Power BI Desktop from Microsoft.com. For this, you can open any browser and then you have to write Power BI Desktop download. You can see the second link. And you can download Microsoft Power BI Desktop here and you can install on your laptop. It's very straightforward. You just need to follow the wizard. After installation, you can open Power BI Desktop and you will see this interface. This interface has been divided into different sections. The first section under home, you can see different options like get data, recent sources, enter data, edit queries, and a lot of other options. And the second section, you can see filter, then visualizations, fields, under view, there are different settings. Under modeling, you can see different like new measure, new column, new table, and a lot of other things that we will see with the passage of time. The objective of this lecture is to see different available data sources and how to get data. If you click get data, you will see different data sources. If you click more, you will see different categories like files contain these categories. These file systems are available like Excel, text, XML, JSON. Under databases, you can see different databases that are available, Power, Azure, online service, and some other. For this lecture, we have to see how to get data from Excel. Let me show you which Excel data we are using. You will find this Excel file under course resource files. If I double click demo data, you will see different sheets available here. Calendar, customer, product, territory, and some other sheets. So we have to import this data into the Power BI. For this, you have to click get data, then Excel. And then you have to go to your file, demo-like, demo data. You can download this demo data in your particular location. After clicking demo data, it will read all the values from different sheets. And you will see different sheets here, like calendar, customer, dim product. And if you click calendar, you will see the relevant fields like ID, date, and some other columns that you have seen in the Excel file. You need to just click all. We have two options here. First is load and the other is transform data. If I click load, it will load all the data into the data model. And if I click transform data, it will give me the option to do any kind of transformation like adding or deleting column, or I can change the data type. So let me show you. If you click on load, you will see here you can see we have different tabs. The first one is a report tab, the other is data tab, and then we have model. And if you click on the data tab, you will see different columns and your data like calendar data, customer, dim product category, subcategory, and everything. Here you have your, if you want to change any data type, or you can any, you want to delete any column, what you can do is you have to click on the edit queries and Power Query editor window will open, and then you can delete any data, or you can change the data type. For example, if you click here, you can see different data types here, and if you want to delete any column, you can delete. For example, here you can see remove column, so this column has been removed from the data model but not from the physical file. If you click close and apply, then it will again load to the data model. Let me show you the other option. Here you can click get data, Excel, demo data, and choose your data here, and then you have to click transform data. It will bring you to the Power Query editor. Here you can do all your transformation. You can change data type, you can add or remove column, and then after, like if I click here and I select this column, then remove column by clicking on the remove column, or I can change the data type, then it will be loaded into the data model. See, here you can see all the data. So one more thing is, like if I delete any column, any table here, just right click and delete from model, it will not be deleted from the physical file. So see, calendar is gone, and if I open demo data here, here you can see calendar data is there. Let's see you in the next lecture.